So myself, Venkat Harish, I'm from St. Martin's Engineering College. So today we will discuss the concept that is subject in the basic mechanical engineers. So the basic mechanical engineer subject is purely related to the civil engineers. So what are all the basic points we require? So what are the units we will cover, that we will see one by one. So in the main subject, in this subject, in the unit, what you will understand at the end of the session. So that is first, the working principle. So today the topic is about the refrigeration. So at the end of the session, so what we will understand, what is the working principle of refrigeration, so how it will be works, so what are all the components we are using for the output results, and how it will be transferred, the position from, that is movement from one place to another place, that is a flow work. So next, what are the unit of refrigeration? So we should measure the output result with respect to the standard units. So likewise, the refrigeration also having some standard values. So that value you will see the one by one. After once, next is the types. So what are all the types it is there in the refrigeration? So how it will be classified? So based on the performance. So that we will see. And finally, the COP. COP is nothing but the coefficient of performance. The coefficient of performance is nothing but the output result. So whatever input we are supplying into the system, so what we will get output from the system. So that overall result is nothing but its performance. So that is nothing but coefficient of performance. So that the concept of today is the refrigeration. So we know that refrigeration we are using the domestic purpose, that is refrigerator. So why we require the refrigerator? So refrigerant is required to maintain the below temperature compared to outside temperature. The inside the refrigeration should be low temperature. So there is a small example here. Just observe the schematic diagram. So at the bottom there is a P in nothing but a power supply. Power is inside. So QR is nothing but heat rejection. So we are giving the power supply, and finally we are removing the heat from the object. So if you remove the heat from the object, then only it is possible to get the lower temperature. So that's why we are getting the inside the refrigerator as a lower temperature compared to ambient temperature or atmospheric temperature. So refrigeration. So how we can understand? So the refrigeration means the refrigeration is nothing but it is a cooling space, or we should maintain the temperature below compared to outside temperature. So how we have to maintain lower temperature? So by using the different component with respect to their working principles. So that we will see by diagram. So after that, so in other words, the refrigeration we also call it as an artificial cooling, because human we are doing the cooling process. It is not done by the naturally, we can also possible by artificial. So that's why it is possible with human made. So finally, the refrigeration we are measuring in the terms of tons of refrigeration. So each and every calculation there is a specific units. Likewise, the refrigeration also having the ton of refrigeration. So how we have to measure the tons of refrigeration, that we will see next. So the 1 ton of refrigeration, so how we are measuring? So for standard definitions, all we are considering with some basic level. So the basic consideration is what? Here we are considering the water, the substance at 0 degree Celsius, and quantity we are considering the 1000. So the 1000 is nothing but the 1 ton. So the definition is nothing but the amount of refrigeration effect is produced by uniform melting of 1 ton of ice from 0 degree Celsius. So from 0 degree Celsius to convert, so how much heat is required? So that is of 1000 kg. So that overall result is nothing but the 1 ton of refrigeration. The standard value of 1 ton of refrigeration is 232.6 kilojoules per minute. So at the time of calculation, if they not given the value of 1 ton of refrigeration, so at that time directly select the value 232.6 kilojoules per minute. So that is the unit of refrigeration. So next, coefficient of performance. The coefficient of performance is nothing but the input and output results. So whatever the possible good results we are getting from the refrigeration or any component, so that is nothing but its performance measurement. So coefficient of performance, how we are measuring? So by using the input and output. So the performance of refrigeration system is expressed by a term, coefficient of performance. So it is the ratio of heat extracted. So obviously we know that in the refrigeration what will happen, it will extract, it will absorb the heat from the object or substance and it will be delivered to the outside. So that is the thing, but heat extracted in the refrigerator to the work done on the refrigerant. So work done produced by the refrigerant and heat extracted. If we know these two values, obviously we will get the final result of the critical coefficient of performance. So how we have to mention in the mathematically, that is theoretical coefficient of performance is nothing but heat extracted divided by work done. So that is Q divided by W. So the relative coefficient is nothing but the actual performance, nothing but a theoretical performance. So the actual is nothing but general, the practical. So theoretical is nothing but as per the principal theories. So based on the principal theories, we are going to find the value of CO. So next. So the types of refrigeration system. So what are all the types in the refrigeration? So how it is classified? So I already said the refrigeration is nothing but a artificial, we can also possible, and natural is also possible. So first one, the natural cooling. So how we can get the temperature lower naturally? That is first one, the art of ice making by natural cooling. The first one. Next one, evaporative cooling. Next, cooling by salt solution. So this is done by the natural process. In the atmospheric it will be happen. So coming to the artificial, that is human made cooling, that is nothing. First one, the vapor compression refrigeration system. That is the first and important. Second one, the vapor absorption system. So these two are widely and most commonly used, that is refrigeration system in all the industries and home purposes. So the remaining are this type, that is solar energy based, gas cycle refrigeration, steam jet refrigeration, the thermal refrigeration system and vortex tube refrigeration. So out of these, in your syllabus only we are discussing in detail, that is vapor compression refrigeration and vapor absorption refrigeration. So that is very very important. So first we will understand vapor absorption refrigeration system. So before entering into the diagram, first we will understand what it contains. So what are all the parts it have? So that individual performance of the parts, if you understand, definitely you will get the clear picture about the total layout working. So first, we are using the substance. So refrigerant is nothing but a substance. So we are using majorly the ammonia as a refrigerant and the water as a absorbent. So these two are very very important for the our vapor absorption system. So that is components. So what are all the components it contains? That is vapor absorption system. That is condenser, expansion valve, so expansion valve, evaporator, absorber, pump and condenser. So first we will understand the individual component working. So if you understand the individual component working, so finally if we assemble in the Lie diagram, so obviously it will be clear about the final results. So what will be the condenser work? So the condenser which is used to condensate, the condensate is nothing but remove the temperature from the refrigerant. So while operating in the cycle, the refrigerant will be changes its temperature from low level to high level, high level to low level. In the condenser, what it will do? It will absorb the heat from the refrigerant. So in order to maintain the temperature lower level, we are using the condenser. Coming to the expansion valve. So the expansion valve is nothing but it is a throttle valve. So sudden expansion will be takes place. So at that time what will happen? So due to the sudden expansion, its properties will be changes. That is the pressure, temperature values will be suddenly expanded. So due to that again the property will be either it increases or decreases. Next, evaporator. So evaporator contains the number of coils, nothing but a heat exchanger. So the high temperature will be become low temperature and simultaneously the low temperature will be become high temperature. So likewise the evaporator will be change the heat property of a refrigerator. So coming to the absorber. So the name itself indicates it will absorb the heat. So whatever the refrigerant it is flowing over the circuit, the refrigerant, the property of absorber is it will absorb the heat from the substance and it will deliver outside. So and finally, next is the pump. So pump, we know that the general component which is used to transfer the substance from one location to another location. For that purpose, we are using majorly the pump. So whether it should be increasing the pressure or decreasing the pressure. So pump, the intention is to transfer the motion from one location to another location of a refrigerator. And finally, the generator. So the generator is nothing but a power element used to transfer the, it will provide the power to the pump for actual accurate performance purpose. Next. So this is about the actual layout of vapor absorption system. So what are the main components observed? The generator, that is water container, condenser, evaporator, observed. So this is the major component it requires. So in the line diagram, observe how the process will be executed one by one. So first, from the observer. So what will happen? We are sending ammonia water. Ammonia and water we are sending to the generator. So generator is a power circuit, power providing element. So it will provide the power to run the pump. So from the generator, what will happen? It will go ammonia vapor plus water. So both will be mixed and we are passing to the water tank here. So what will happen here again? The water and ammonia both will be separates. So that is water and ammonia both will be separates. So only the ammonia vapor is sending to the condenser. So the remaining water, which is again passing to the back to the observer for cooling purpose. So next, from the condenser. So we are sending the ammonia vapor to the condenser. The intention of condenser is what? To reduce the temperature. So when the ammonia vapor will enter into the condenser, its temperature pressure value will be decreases slowly. So after that, the ammonia liquid, observe, the ammonia vapor is entering into the condenser and leaving condenser is ammonia liquid. So ammonia liquid again we are passing to the evaporator. So evaporator is nothing but the heat exchange will be takes place. So in the evaporator again, the ammonia is mixed with the hydrogen mixture. So from the hydrogen mixture again it is passing to the observer. So again the observer will observe the heat from the system or object in the whatever we are placing inside the refrigeration. So again separation takes place, the hydrogen gas is again re-back to the evaporator and observer, that is ammonia or water again we are passing to the refrigerator. Again the cycle will be continuously repeats. This is about the layout of vapor absorption system. So that is major intention. So vapor absorption is over. Next is the vapor compression is over. Next, vapor absorption working. So how it will be work? So what are all the components just we saw that? So now we will see in this type of refrigeration produced for evaporation in the system by the observer. So we know that observer is used to evaporating purpose. Next, the heat absorber consists of homogeneous mixture. So observer, it contains the mixture of ammonia water. So that mixture we are passing to the generator for transmission to water separator. So after separating there, again we are finally sending the ammonia vapor to the condenser. In the condenser output we will get the ammonia water only. So that kind of process will be continuously generator is circulating and the heat will be transferred or heat will be delivered to the outside. So that is the major concept of the working in the vapor absorption system. Next, the liquid ammonia which is at high pressure is passed to the expansion valve. So the intention of expansion valve is what? To change the properties. If sudden expansion takes place, what will happen? Its pressure and temperature value will be changes. So after expansion, what will happen? The wet ammonia vapor at low temperature and pressure will be the result. So sudden expansion is nothing but its temperature pressure values will be suddenly decreases. So because of that reason, it will be reduce the temperature. So next, finally the vapor is then passed to the evaporator. The evaporator absorbs the heat and dry it, and finally the vapor will be again recirculated to the generator, condenser, observer, and heat circulation will be continuously moving on. So this is about the actual working process of vapor absorption system. This is one important concept. So next is about its performance. So how we have to measure the vapor absorption system? So that is the coefficient of performance of vapor absorption refrigeration will falling with the definite value, that is the formula. So COP is equal to heat absorbed during the evaporator. So divided by work done by the pump plus heat supplied in the heat exchanger. So if we knowing these values, we can easily obtain the performance of vapor absorption system. So that is the final working of a vapor absorption system. Thank you.